This is one of these great swans with a lot of flexibility. It's an eye drop filler, but it still has a screw-on cap with a flange in the front that limits any escaping ink. So, I just filled this up last night, as you can see. It's got some ink on the nib, but you unscrew it. And fill the barrel with ink, and you screw it back in again. I like to put a bit of wax in it, because you really do have to have a watertight seal, and you don't want to make it too tight because you don't want to shear off the threading. So a little bit of help is nice. This is fine, but very flexible. And it has good flow with pretty wet line. Now, copper plate is great, but one thing that I like to do best with a flexible nib is ordinary Roman letters, because you can get those thick and thin lines. Then you can have the slightly mannered letters that you see in, for example, the Parker trademark in the 20s and 30s. Got a little bit of that there, where the flow didn't match the movement of the nib. One thing about these old nibs is they were intended to be used like this. Just ordinary writing without pressing down. Just an occasional bit of pressing down. They weren't really intended for an engrosser's hand where every single downstroke is thick. So they weren't designed to flow so that every single thick downstroke was filled. You do get some of that. But this is better than most 20s pens in that way. You get a little bit there. See, after several pressurized downstrokes, you got one hollow one. Well, that's going to happen.